All right, welcome back inside our Proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Francois Perron, the CEO of Lucky Minerals. And Francois, welcome back. Nice to see you again.
Likewise.
So big news out from the company today that you've got some drill results out from the Wayka Project in Ecuador. And I know you've been waiting a long time to get some drilling done. And so maybe start with, you know, what's going on as far as the drilling is concerned. This isn't overly deep, right? This is just the sort of the initial start to it.
That's correct. Okay. And I mean, I've been telling people I was going to drill this. We've had some difficulties getting the drilling equipment set up properly. We reconfigured to a very lightweight. So we're drilling shallower holes between 50 and 150 meters. And we can do that because we have stuff that outcrops. So I think there's a lot of information to be gained. So what you have now is the first five drill holes for a grand total of 368 meters. So it's a little bit humbling. It's a very small start. Okay. But at least the statement today is like, there's a couple of things people should take away. It's very early. So like, I'm not expecting that the discovery hole is there. I am trying to show people we are drilling right now in the middle of what's been a tricky time to drill. We are able to drill. We have the local support. And now we have a configuration that I think works. And we've been able to get the five drill holes done, 368 meters. In there, there's about 20 meters that carries more than 0.3. So obviously, there's gold in the drill holes. And now, what did we get? Well, unfortunately, I was aiming to get the feeders so that I could get grades similar to what we had in the trenches. What did we hit? We hit things that the mineralization's along the foliation, and you'll see it in the section that I put in the press release. But because we're along the foliation, basically our interpretation is this is probably leaking from a feeder, but we didn't hit the feeder. So like the high grades are probably there and around it. The problem is it's super early. This is the very, very first time this is drilled. It's a brand new project. And lo and behold, things are different than what we interpreted at surface. That's almost par for the course for an exploration program. You don't get that usually anymore because you don't have brand new projects anymore. This is a brand new project from surface. And this is the initial drilling. And now this lightweight drill, I can just keep it up there and we're going to keep drilling. Every time we drill, we get more information. We're going to hit those feeders.
So in essence, where you're looking at right now was, and you mentioned trenching. So the trenching program that you had done, which was quite extensive, so you're following along with the results that came from the trenching program in order where you want to sort of continue to take a look. Is that?
Yeah, so we drilled right underneath. So I had a high grade trench here. I drilled underneath. Yeah. I didn't hit the same structures exactly that were in those trenches, and the grades, there's gold, so we're around those systems, but we're not hitting them. So it's like, I probably didn't have the right angle. So it's like the game of battleship begins, okay? Three-dimensional battleship is what it is, but that's what it is. And after five holes in three different areas, okay, it's normal, and we got a lot of information, and we have a plan as to how we're going to test things going forward. And in the meantime, we've also done work up at the Kelly Zone where we've hit a lot of 1 gram material. And there, the breccia is a different configuration. Here, the breccias in the discovery zone are tight, structurally controlled. So about 5 meters wide on average is what we're seeing in the trenches. Up at the Kelly Zone, we've seen the breccia for 100 meters by 40 meters wide is what we've identified at surface. Some areas in that breccia carry 1 gram, others less than that. Clearly, we have to get a drill up there, too, to test that out. So there's a lot more work to do, and we're going to do more surface work up at the Kelly area because we haven't reached, we don't understand how that breccia manifests itself, so we don't have a clear drilling strategy yet.
Okay, but the drilling will continue from where the results are coming from right now. So you're going to continue there, yeah?
The drill is down this week. We're fine-tuning a couple of things. We jointly with the driller that's taking shares for services, we've developed this solution. So there's a little bit of custom job that we're doing that that there's things that we're improving on the design. We'll probably get a bit deeper with that and better recoveries. And so we're doing that this week, and then we'll get the drill back up there. A drill hole takes about a week and a half, and then, you know, we bring it down, we log it, turn around at the labs about 15 days. So it's like, we're going to continue to have news flow. It's not like normally people say, oh, I'm going to do 3,000, then they put out results, and then we'll talk to you again in 8 months. Okay, this is continuous drilling, basically. I got something going. The holes are short. They don't take long. So I'm probably, unless I hit the jackpot and it's material, probably continue to do monthly updates like this, where I got three or four more.
Okay, that makes a lot of sense. Yeah, Francois, thank you so much. Good update. Good to talk to you as well. And we'll talk very soon again.
Hopefully next month.
Sounds good. There's Francois Perron, the CEO of Lucky Minerals.